Hello everyone, very warm welcome to Think Constructive. I am Isha. Today's session is on simple web server. It's an important addition in Java 18. Okay, so let us start with the simple web server discussion. So in this session of simple web server, I will be giving you the introduction of simple web server followed by its use cases, do's and don'ts of simple web server followed by the techniques with which you can implement it. All right, so stay connected, watch the session till the end so that nothing is missed. Okay, so let us start with the simple web server discussion. So what is simple web server? What we all understand from its name, it's simple web server. That means it is the simplest web server which can be used for, you know, basic internal testing, unit testing, or, you know, educational purposes or debugging purposes. All right, that means it is the why Java has introduced it, because it is one of the missing feature of Java, I would say. Why? Because if someone has to do some kind of internal stuff, some web server should be supported by the programming language itself, so that developer or tester need not to look anywhere else. They will just make use of the things provided by the programming language itself. Nonetheless, that missing feature is now introduced by Java in Java 18. All right, so if you really want to use this feature, download and install Java 18 in your systems. Okay, so what is the feature ID for this one? It is JP408. With JP408 feature ID, Java 18 has introduced this feature. Okay, it is a simple, very simple, lightweight feature. And you know, if you need to do some internal testing or those kind of stuffs, you can make use of this feature. The next key point is it serves only single directory hierarchy. Okay, because it's the bare minimum web server which is provided by the programming language, so it will serve only a single directory hierarchy, not, you know, a very great lucrative feature it is giving. It is giving you all the bare minimum basic feature of a web server. Okay, the next one is it is a minimalistic static web server. So static, that means it will be serving you only the static resources. So if you are looking for runtime resources, this feature is not for you. The next one, it is a lightweight server, as we have already discussed, and it's not at all a feature rich one. All right, so this is about what is simple web server. Now I'll be talking about the use cases of simple web server. The first use case, what I can say is it is an in-memory file server for unit testing. So as a developer, if you are looking forward to unit test and have some kind of in-memory file server, the simple web server can help you there. All right, what is the next use case for that? It will serve zip file system for internal testing. So for internal testing, being a developer or tester, if you are looking forward to, you know, check or do something with the zip file system, it can serve you that. The next important feature or the use case for this is web application internal testing. So if you are a web developer or a web tester, you can use this feature for web application internal testing. What is the another use case? If you are looking forward to do some kind of debugging stuffs, it can serve you the entire JRT. All right, we'll see the demonstration also, so stay connected. So it can serve the static content for the testing stuffs. All right, so now we'll have a quick look on the key points, the do's and don'ts for this server, and then we'll move towards the techniques for implementing it. All right, so here is the support, and what does it support and what is not supported. So what is supported with SWS, that is simple web server, that is HTTP 1.1 only. So please make it a point that it supports only HTTP 1.1 protocol, and it does not support HTTP 2 or HTTPS protocol. So any other higher-end HTTP protocols are not supported because it is just a lightweight minimal server. All right, only idempotent requests, those are head and get. Those requests are served only. All right, there is no service for post and put request. If you will try to do so, you will always get 501 or 405 errors. All right, so make it a point, you only use it for head and get. Okay, in this server, MIME types are already configured. So for example, for Java files, text plane will be automatically configured. And also, once the server starts successfully, it will run until it is stopped. Alright, so let's say you are using a terminal, you need to issue Control C command. I'll show that demonstration also to you. Okay, and it does not support any kind of security. Please keep it in mind. If you want to use it for any security testing or any security purposes, this server is not for you. It does not support any kind of security, that is OAuth or HTTPS, etc. Those kind of protocols are not supported. Alright, so let us now have a look in which or whichever way this server can be implemented. How we can implement this server? The first technique is command line tool. So the moment you will install Java 18 in your system, inside the bin directory you will find this jwebserver tool, right? So if you want to use it via command line, you can just make use of this jwebserver tool and your server will be up and running. If you want to do it via program, you have another method, that is the API one. That means you can program and make this server up for the specific needs. Alright, so we'll now see the demonstration for both the techniques one by one. So keep watching till the end so nothing is missed. Alright, and if you are liking the session, hit the like button. Don't miss it. So now let's have a look at the jwebserver demonstration and then we'll see the API one. Okay. So here is the terminal window and I'm already inside my Java 18 installation bin directory. I will just show you the path so that you can get to know where you should be looking for jwebserver tool. Alright, so here is my Java 18 is installed and I'm already inside bin directory. I will list down the contents now and you can see jwebserver is here. Alright, so I will now execute jwebserver so that you can get to know how it should be working. Alright, I'll just say enter and see it is binding to the loopback by default, serving my current directory. This is the directory we have just now seen and all the subdirectories of it on my loopback address, default port 8000. And finally, the URL constructed is this one. Note that HTTP is mentioned here. So this is what we discussed. It works on HTTP 1.1. All right. Now let us check how this URL is working and what is it serving to us. All right. So here is a browser window. Here I'll give the URL where it is shown me that it is serving some data and I'll hit enter. What am I getting here? The directory listing for // is my current directory. So by default it serves a content of current directory and I can see all other executables mentioned inside the bin of Java 18 installation directory. All right, so now what I will do, I will switch back to the terminal window and I will show you how you can terminate this server, because by default it will keep working until you will terminate it. So I'll just issue SIGINT, that is Control C, and my server is terminated. Now we will see the jwebserver help window and then we'll come back to some customization. All right, how we can do that? I will just say jwebserver-h, which is the help option. What is it telling me? The bind address, by default bind address is always the loopback address. If you would want to change, you will have to use -b. Okay, by default directory is current directory, and if you would like to change the current directory, you should be using this -d symbol. Alright, by default the output is info. If you would want to change that info to none, let's say for some reason you don't want to see any output or you want to make it verbose, you can use the switch -o. Default port is 8000, which we have just now seen, but if I want to change the port because of some reason, I can use that -p or -port. All right, and help we have just now seen, and similarly version. Okay, so now I will show you how you can change the port. By default you have seen 8000 was working. Now I would want to change the port to 8888, let's say. Okay, I'll hit enter. Everything is up and running, no issues, and this time the URL constructed is 8888 port. All right, so now I will switch back to the browser window. We'll see what are we getting there. All right, so earlier 8000 was working. I'll just hit refresh and let us see what happens. Nothing is here, but we have seen my server is working. That means what should I do now? I will give 8888 and hit enter. What am I getting? I am getting the entire directory listing here now because I have just now changed the port. All right. Okay. So now I will terminate the server to change the current directory. Okay. And let us see what happens. Let's say now I want to change the directory to users isha library. How do I do that? I will again start the server, but this time with the new directory. All right. So it should be serving me now the contents of users isha library directory. All right. I will hit enter. My server is started, but notice serving this particular thing, which is what we wanted. All right. And default port is 8000. So now this 8888 doesn't work because we have now again started the server at the default port. Okay. And see what all I am getting. I am getting all different directory listing, which is definitely not the Java installation directory, something else, because we have changed it to slash users isha. All right. And again, I am getting my output in the similar manner. So this is about jwebserver command line tool demonstration. If you have any more questions, you can ask the same in the comment section. Leave your thoughts there because that will be very, very helpful. So now let us have the demonstration of SWS via program or API. All right. So for this demonstration, I will be using IntelliJ editor. You can use any editor of your choice. It's totally up to you. Any Java editor. All right. Here is my IntelliJ editor and I have already opened a new project here. Although nothing is added inside, it is just a simple new Java 18 project. You can notice I am building a Maven project. You can notice the Maven compiler source and target is set to 18. Okay, I will also show you the project structure properties, wherein you can be very clear that what Java version we are using. So C project SDK is set to OpenJDK 18. All right. So for trying out this demonstration, you should be using Java 18. So Java 18 has to be installed at your systems or in your editor. All right. So I'll just click OK and come back to the project. Here in the project, you can see a simple structure, project structure. It's like SRC main Java resources. All right. So inside Java, I will just add a new Java class. Let's say I will add it inside my package structure, which is com think constructive. Okay. And then my Java class name, suppose I am giving SWS .jrt.demo. Okay, I'll just say enter. So since this project is already added to the Git, it is asking me whether I want to add this file there or not. I would just go ahead and add it. Okay, so SWS JRT demo. So I'll just put a code block here and the code block will be serving the Java runtime directory for remote debugging purposes. All right, so I'll just put the code here. What am I getting? SWS JRT demo was my class and what I have done, I have created a loopback address. And how do I do that? I will just create a new object, new inet socket address. Inside that inet address dot get loopback address and then the port 8888 or whichever port you would want. In my case, I'm using this because I know for sure this port is free. All right. And inside my main class, I have created a file system. Inside that URI to create the JRT, all right, because this is what I want to serve. Absolute path will be, how can I get the absolute path from the file system modules? I will just say to absolute path, and in after that I will create the HTTP server. How would I do that? I will just say simple file server dot create file server with the parameters as loopback address, absolute path, and simple file server dot output level. Let me just shift it to next line. All right. So simple file server dot output level dot info. By default, I am giving info here. If you want, you can probably suppress. If you want to suppress the output logging level, you can suppress it by giving it to none. All right. And after that, I will just say HTTP server start. So this will start the HTTP server. Main point to be noted here, simple file server is a new class which is added inside comsunnet HTTP server package. This server was already existing prior to Java 18 also, but inside that simple file server is a new class added for writing the programs for simple web server. All right, that is where I'm using this simple web server class dot create file server to create the HTTP server, which will actually start my simple web server. And according to this code, it will start serving the Java runtime directories. All right, for again debugging purposes. Okay, so this is how you should be writing SWS program. And now let me just execute this program and show you the results. All right, how do I do that? I will just say run this main. Okay, it is starting the server, and what am I getting here? I have got the window without any error. That means my server should have been started at what? Loopback address. That means my localhost colon 8888. Let me see what do we get there. So I will just say 127.0.1:8888 and hit enter. What am I getting? I'm getting entire Java runtime directory listing here. And if I want to go inside a particular directory or see something, I will just click on this and can go inside. All right, I can go inside com, sun, crypto, provider. What else do I want? I'm getting all the classes file, and I can pick up any class file for the debugging purposes from here. So this feature is going to be very, very helpful for such kind of activities. All right. So here in the IntelliJ editor, you can see in this logging window, I'm getting all sorts of logging. See what we did. We clicked on Java base. We have got HTTP 1.1.3.1 response. Then again inside Java base 200 response, 301, 200 till crypto provider. I'm getting all the logging here. All right. This is because of output level info. If you would want, you can change it or to none or verbose, whichever way you would want to use it. All right, so this is about making SWS up and running via program. All right, remember this simple file server class. This is very, very important for writing such kind of programs. Okay, so I hope you found this demonstration very useful and you would want to give it a try. In case you would want to take this code, you can check the my git repo link, which is given in the description box below. That's all about simple web server, what, why, how, and about the majority or the main use cases. All right. If you have any more questions on simple web server, please feel free to ask them in the comment section below. Thank you everyone for watching this session. I hope you enjoyed it. And if so, then subscribe to the channel and hit the like button. See you in the next session soon. Bye for now.